It's cold. Colder than usual. Looking up at the sky, it's dull. Reminds me of her. And I look into her face. It was lifeless. She showed no emotion, or at least tried. I could see in her deep blue eyes that she felt something. Was it remorse? Sorrow? Detective Miles Archer, I'd like to ask you a few questions, Mr. Dupre.
It's Dupre, actually.
Tell me about Richard Blaine.
I wouldn't know what to say.
He was found dead today, Brimley Forth. Shot three times in the back from point blank range.
That doesn't explain why I'm here.
I know you knew Richard, Mr. Prey. These photos of you were found in Mr. Blaine's wallet. Care to explain? What was your relation to him?
We were lovers for a while, but it came to a bitter end and I haven't seen him since.
Did you kill him because of his newfound love? Because he still loved you and you had the promise of money?
I didn't kill him.
What about your hairs we found in him? You must have met him not long before his death.
I can't explain that. I don't know how it got there.
Seems quite convenient, don't you think?
Mr. Archer, maybe you should be investigating someone with a real motive rather than wasting your time interrogating me.
There was a shoe print to the scene.
And you think that's mine just because you falsely accused me of murder?
We also found the shoe. Would you mind? A perfect fit.
I won't see my lawyer.
Veronica Dupre, I'm arresting you on the suspicion of murder. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. To find the truth, you must look at little things. Some say I'm a liar and a murderer. Maybe I did frame an innocent woman, but someone had to take the fall. Can't be me. I'm justice.
I'm all washed out by the side of the road. Broken bones, Matilda left a note in the road saying, baby, honey, child, I love you so long, but you deserve much better than me.